Hi, welcome back. This is Rachel Zuffa, and I'm going to do something a little bit different on this book talk. I am going to discuss a book that doesn't come out yet. It'll be out a week from Tuesday when this airs. That's April 28th. And part of the reason I want to do this differently is, one, it is a new book that hasn't come out yet, and I received an ARC from a wonderful editor, Brian Geffen, and I would like to thank you very much. A little shout out to you. This was a book that he worked on as an editor and thought that I would very much enjoy, and you very much get me because it is a book I very much enjoyed. So because it is a new book, I wanted to give it some focus time and some air time, and it's also a debut novel. And so I wanted to also give it some special notice and recognition. Secondly, the topic that it has to deal with, I feel, needs a little bit more space. And it has to deal with suicide. And I feel, not just suicide, it has to deal with mental health and domestic violence. And so I feel when there is a book that has to do with such sensitive topics, and it is done so well, and it's also a debut novelist, it deserves to have a little bit more space to breathe in. So, without further ado, I'm going to go ahead and talk about the book, which is A Breath Too Late by Rocky Callan. And if I'm saying your last name wrong, Rocky, please forgive me. But the book's phenomenal. So, one of the things I would also like to go ahead and state is Rocky has mentioned on her Instagram account, at Rocky Writes, that in the month of May, this May 2020, she will be doing a book discussion with young adults about her book. So if this sounds like something that interests you, go ahead and pre-order it from your favorite indie bookstore and pick it up. You can order it to, of course, if you prefer to do an e-reader, because this is going to be something I highly recommend that you want to get involved with when you can work directly with the author. And one of the things I like to point out about the author as well is that in her introduction, she states that these are some of the things that she has gone through in her life, but she is a behavioral therapist as well. Which to me gives it extra high marks. This is somebody who has background in training and understands what she is talking about. And in the index, in the very back, not index, but in the very back, there are a list of resources too for help. From the very beginning, this book had me. It starts off with beautiful and wonderful and creative and fierce and brave Ellie. And from the very first chapter, Ellie commits suicide. And so she is already gone. And it is an interesting way to start a book in which your protagonist has already left and has made that choice. And so you don't know her yet. You don't know what she's like and why she's done what she's done. And each of the entries begins as a letter to mom, to mama, to August, her friend, and someone she loves deeply and has known all of her life, most of her life, to dad. Sometimes it's to life itself. Sometimes it's to death. Sometimes to words. Ellie wants to be a writer. But the thing that first happens is that Ellie doesn't really know what happens. She is a ghost in her own life. And when she wakes up, she's ready to go to school and doesn't realize that people can't see her. And she first realizes that she's not there when in her English class, the teacher announces that she's dead. And August, no, he says, no, this didn't happen, no. And Ellie is like, no, like, don't know this. I don't remember this. And what you get is fragments of memories at first. Things that she has forgotten, things that she starts to remember just about her life. Sometimes it's when she's really young. But it's always when she's next to somebody that she loves. And it's a memory connected to them. And slowly she starts to build what was her life around her. And as she builds her life around her, she gathers enough of who she was to remember why she did what she did. It is at times, for me, it was a very heartrending book. And I'm going to be really honest because I feel that, and Rocky herself says this, I feel like the more that you share your story, and I say this too so far in the book talk, that your story is valuable. I feel the more it's connects each of us. But I suffer from depression and anxiety, and people who know me know that it's something that I'm very open about. I wasn't always, but I am now. But I also suffer from trauma in my childhood. And going through this book and reading it, there were times I needed to stop. Ellie, for example, talks about how it's hard to breathe. It's hard to breathe when she's in her home. And I could feel that feeling. There were times when I was in my home as a child and I didn't think I could breathe. So you would often find me outside in the backyard because I wasn't really allowed to go too many places at certain times. Not because of my mother, but because of my father. And play with the dogs. We always had dogs. My dad was a hunter because it was the one time when I felt like I could breathe. It's a strange feeling to feel like you're being suffocated within your own home. And this is the descriptions and the way that it is written, for me at least, felt quite real. Real enough that I had to put the book down at times. The way that she describes depression and the way that it can creep up on you, and it doesn't mean that you're always walking around like, oh, but the way that sometimes your days are okay and sometimes they're not okay. The way that some families keep secrets, because that's just what you do. I mean, you don't necessarily advertise, hey, this is what's going on. It felt very true and very real for me, as an individual who has grown up with a lot of these sorts of things. And so I deeply appreciated the raw honesty and truthfulness that comes out of these pages. And I think one of the important things to recognize too, and that Ellie recognizes throughout her journey as she's piecing together the parts of herself, is she's able to step outside for once of her depression. And when you are living with something like depression and anxiety, at least this is true for me, it's very difficult to step outside of yourself. So for example, if someone says to you, if you're just having a bad day, this, and you don't even have to have anxiety or depression, but if you're just having a bad day and somebody says, you're gonna be fine. Oh my God, you're right. I feel great. It doesn't work like that. Like, I mean, you would really love it if life worked like that, if somebody came up to you and said, you are gonna be great. And all of a sudden you're like, oh, you saying that made me great. It would be wonderful if that's how it worked. And the truth is it doesn't work like that. But because of Ellie's situation, because she is a ghost now outside of where she is, she gets a different perspective on what is going on with what was her life. She sees the individuals that she loved and cared for from a different point of view because she's no longer there. And that's not, that's, I'm not recommending to do this sort of a thing, But a lot of the time, when you have depression that is riding you, at least for me, it's very difficult to step outside of that, and to see what's going on with somebody else, because it's a mask that divides you or separates you from everything else that is going on. And what I'd like to say definitely, to Rocky, is thank you. From someone who has gone through this, from someone who has lost people that I love to suicide, and who has people that I deeply, deeply love who have attempted suicide, I felt that this was such an incredibly strong and beautiful way of examining what this means, because it is something that impacts all of us. So, A Breath Too Late. I highly recommend it. Again, it's going to be coming out a week from next Tuesday on April 28th. At Rocky Writes on Instagram is the author's account. And for young adults, she's going to be doing a wonderful book talk, book discussion. And I think it's going to be wonderful. I'm wondering how I can disguise myself as a young adult, get involved in it. And again, I would like to give a shout out at Brian Geffen, a part of the Holt McMillan team, for providing me with the ARC. This is a great experience, and I really appreciate it. And I do hope that those of you who feel like this is a book that might speak to you, who are interested in topics like this, pick it up. Because it's highly impactful and provides some really great resources for those who need it. So, until then, be kind to yourself, show compassion to yourself, and remember your story is important because you are the only one who has it. And